As we know from both HTML element hierarchy and Louisiana civil code, elements can pass text style information down through to their children. We can set text styles on parent elements, which pass styling down, and we can override these styles on their child elements. And we're going to show three examples to demo this. That's it. We'll start with the first one. Let's look at this ultra simple layout. We have our page body, then inside that we have our section, then a container inside the section. Let's drag in a paragraph to join our heading. Now, we've applied no classes, no styling of any type to any of these elements. And by default, if we check our paragraph, press our orange indicator, we can see it's getting the font from the body. Let's select the body, and with the body selected, we'll change the font. Now, because this updates in real time, this part has already been spoiled. We know that our heading and our paragraph are inheriting this new font change from the body. We can override this, though. Make a change. Now we have a blue indicator, which of course shows us that we've made a style change here. Or we can remove that. Again, if we click the indicator, it's inheriting from the body. And keep in mind, while the body is the top-level element, we'll have to apply that body class, which was automatically created when we changed the font, we'll have to apply that to the body on other pages too. A great alternative, and we'll remove this class right now, is to go in and select our body all pages tag. Changes here will set those defaults on all pages in the project. That's example one. Example two is a section. And even though it's not a text element, we can apply font styling here too. First, let's see where it's coming from. Of course, it's coming from our body tag for all pages. With our section selected, let's override this font, and while we're at it, let's change the font color too. Notice how the heading and paragraph inside, both child elements of the section, notice how these are affected by the changes. That's because this override broke the chain of inheritance. Before, the section's child elements, the heading and the paragraph, didn't have any indication from their direct parents, like the container or the section, regarding font. The section and the container weren't specifying anything, so the heading and paragraph looked all the way up the hierarchy to the body for that styling info, so it didn't matter. But since we've added styling to the section, that's overriding that styling. If we take a closer look at the inheritance, we can see the value is now coming from the section. Just like we overrode the body earlier, we can do the same thing here. Any child element can override text styling. We can see our blue indicator, which means exactly that. Let's remove it, and again, we're inheriting from our section. That's example two. Example three is a link block. Same idea here. Here's some text sitting inside a link block. We could style the text directly, or we could simply select the link block and change the styling here. Once we do that, we can go in and select our text. Where is this style value coming from? Of course, it's coming from our link block. We can override at any time, or we can remove that and check to see that, yet again, we're inheriting that style value from the link block. So, regardless of the context or the element type, text styling passes down through the hierarchy unless it's been overridden.